Hello, all of my friends, and welcome to our second virtual story time of the summer. I'm Eleanor, and I'm so excited to be reading books with you today. First, let's get our bodies ready for story time with a little bit of singing and a little bit of dancing. Today, we're going to sing a dance to a Raffi classic. If you're happy and you know it, you probably know this one. But if you don't, here is some music to help you. Let's get started.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're bananas and you know it, let it ring. If you're bananas and you know it, let it ring. If you're bananas and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're bananas and you know it, let it ring. If you're beautiful and you know it, shout hooray. If you're beautiful and you know it, shout hooray. If you're beautiful and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're beautiful and you know it, shout hooray. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
All right, now that we've gotten our bodies ready for story time, let's do some reading. The books in this story time are all about things that you can do during the summer, like going to the pool, and eating cold sweet treats and camping. Because even though it's the end of July, we still have so much summer left and you have so much time to do all of those fun summer things and more. All right, let's read our first book. It's an Elephant and Piggy book. It's a classic called Should I Share My Ice Cream by Mo Willems. Ooh, look at all of those ice cream cones. See any flavors that you like? Should I Share My Ice Cream by Mo Willems. Ice cream! Get your cold ice cream for a hot day!
Oh boy! Ice cream! One ice cream, please.
Here you go!
Oh boy! Oh boy! I love ice cream.
Me too, Gerald.
Wait! Piggy loves ice cream, too.
Piggy is his best friend.
Oh, Piggy is my best friend. Should I share my ice cream with her?
Ooh. Look, he's holding it with his trunk. That's so amazing.
Should I share my awesome, yummy, sweet, super, great, tasty, nice, cool ice cream?
Look, this word bubble is even shaped like an ice cream cone. Ooh, he's staring at that ice cream. He really wants to eat it, doesn't he?
Maybe Piggy does not like this flavor. Sharing a flavor Piggy does not like would be wrong. I will eat the ice cream.
Oh, do you see what's happening to his ice cream cone right now? Do you see that? What's happening? Looks like it's getting
hot. Wait. Piggy will like this flavor. It is very yummy.
Oh my gosh. It's getting drippier and drippier.
I will share my ice cream. It will not be easy.
Ooh, he's sweating. It's dripping, just like his ice cream cone.
Hey, Piggy is not here. She does not know I have ice cream. I will eat the ice cream. Where is Piggy? What if she is sad somewhere?
Oh no, look, he's imagining. And she looks so sad.
I must find her.
Oh, do you see his ice cream cone now?
Oh my gosh.
But in his imagination, it's totally fine.
When I do, I will say, would you like some of my ice cream?
Oh, and she looks pretty excited to see that ice cream, doesn't she?
Then she will say,
thank you, that would cheer me up.
Then I will give her my ice cream to share.
And look, she's eating it. She's saying, yum. Oh, that's so nice of Gerald.
Then my best friend will be happy.
Look at them sharing their ice cream together. Oh, and he's tearing up a little bit.
I will do it. I will share my ice cream. Oh my gosh, what happened to his ice cream cone? No!
Now Piggy cannot have any of my ice cream. Now I cannot have any of my ice cream. I blew it. Do you see that really tiny? He's saying it really tiny because he's so sad.
Well, look who it is.
Do you see who that is? It's Piggy. And what does she have? Gosh. You look sad. Would you like some of my ice cream?
Thank you. That would cheer me up. Yum.
And look what they're doing. They're sharing it together. Oh my gosh.
That was not my plan.
Do you remember what his plan was? His ice cream with Piggy.
Oh well, this works too.
Oh, they're so happy and they're sharing the ice cream together. The end. Look at the ice cream cones now. They're a little meltier. Oh, and who's that? The end. I'm so glad that Gerald and Piggy got to share their ice cream cone at the end. I was a little worried for Gerald back there. In your activity kits that you can pick up at the library, you can make an ice cream cone just like Gerald and Piggy's, except it will never melt. Do you know why? Because it's made out of pom-poms. That is right. In your activity kits, you get a few pom-poms and you get some paper that you can curl up and make into an ice cream cone. I glued mine together, but you can also just stack them on top of each other. And this one will never ever melt. Ooh, but I would only pretend like it because it's kind of fuzzy and I wouldn't want your tongues to get fuzzy like mine just did. Blech. All right, so the next book that we're going to read is also about cold, sweet treats that you can eat in the summer, but it's not about ice cream. It's about paletas, which are like cold, sweet popsicles made with fresh fruit and cream. They're delicious. So this book is called Paletero Man. It's written by Lucky Diaz, who is a singer. He's in a children's band, and he actually wrote a song called Paletero Man, and this book is inspired by that song. It's illustrated by Micah Player. And look at these beautiful illustrations that Micah Player did. Wow. Let's read it. Paletero Man. Ooh, and here's the city. This book takes place in Los Angeles, which is in California. Do you see all of these people? They're really tiny. But some of them are running, and some of them are playing instruments, and some of them are sitting and talking. In the hottest month, on the hottest day, in the city of Dreamers, California, L.A., I grab my dinero and make my way to find my friend Paletero Jose. So there is our narrator. He's got his dinero. He's thinking about all the paletas he's going to eat. Pushing his cart full of cool treats, bailando, he dances to mariachi beats. He has dozens of flavors. I can already taste. Will he have my favorite? There's not a second to waste. There's Tio Ernesto. He asks, tamale today? No gracias, Tio. Where's Paletero Jose?
Oh, look. Tamale stand.
Fresh tamales by Tio. That sounds delicious. Ring, ring, ring. Can you hear his call? Paletas for one. Paletas for all. There goes our narrator. But look. Do you see what he's dropping? Oh, man. That can't be good. Un aroma is calling. caught in the breeze. It's a BBQ smell coming from Miss Lee's. Here's Lee's, and she has Korean barbecue tacos. Wow, that sounds really good. She says, Hola, querido. Would you like a sample today? No, gracias, señorita. Where's Paletero Jose? Oh, man. Do you see what's on the sidewalk here? More of his money. Oh, no. Ring, ring, ring. Can you hear his call? Paletas for one. Paletas for all. Ooh, our narrator is sweating and breathing hard because he's running and because it's hot outside. The only way to beat this heat is with an icy cold paleta treat. There's my friend from the bike shop. Lo siento, Frank. There's no time to stop. Ring, ring, ring. Can you hear his call? Paletas for one. Paletas for all. Oh, man. He's dropping more of his money, and it looks like his friend Frank is trying to warn him. He's like, sorry. Gotta go. He said there's no time to stop. Will he have all the flavors, the colors I love? Horchata, canela, the kind I dream of? Chocolate, elote, sandía o fresa? Arroz con leche, miel o cereza? Ooh, look at all of those delicious flavors. And I can see some grapes down here and strawberries. Ring, ring, ring! Can you hear his call? Paletas for one, paletas for all! Here he is, Paletero Jose. Finally, I'll get cool on this very hot day. There's Paletero Jose. He's saying, Oye, niños, what will it be? And look at all these kids and families who are coming to get their paletas. So exciting. He has all my favorites. Can it be true? Chocolate, vainilla, y melon, too. But today I'd like piña. Do you have that sabor? He smiles a big smile. Claro. Para ti, el mejor. That means, of course, for you, the best. I reach into my pocket to pay for my paleta. Do you think he's going to have enough money to pay for his paleta? I don't know. Let's see. Mi dinero! Mi money! Está perdido! It's missing. It's lost. ¿A dónde se ha ido? What will I do? What can I say? How can I buy my paleta today? How do you think he's going to pay for his paleta? And just at that moment, who do I see? My neighborhood friends, Tio, Frank, and Miss Lee. Look what they have. They have his money. We called out your name when we saw your coins drop, but you must not have heard us because you didn't stop. Muchas gracias, amigos. What would I have done? I guess I dropped my money when I was on the run. That is so kind of his neighbors. Kindness for all, shouts Paletero Jose. I have a surprise that will brighten your day. Oye, amigos, paletas on me. Because of your kindness, the paletas are free. That is so kind of Paletero Jose. Ooh, and that paleta looks really good. Whether it's stormy or whether it's sunny, whether or not you have any money, I'll always help out an amigo in need. Yo te prometo, an amigo indeed. Yo te prometo means I promise you. Look at all of these kids and these families who get their paletas. Even Tio and Frank and Miss Lee. It's so exciting. In the hottest month, on the hottest day, we have fun in the sun with Paletero Jose. Ring, ring, ring. We can hear his call. Paletas for one, paletas for all. Look at all of these people. Can you see what they're all doing? There's someone playing music, people riding in boats, and people playing with frisbees, all while enjoying their paletas for free. The end. Yum. Now I'm hungry for ice cream and paletas. And in your activity kit, you could also make paletas that will never melt because they're made out of paper. Whoops, I dropped one. You can color them to be whatever flavor you would like, and then you can cut them out and put them on popsicle sticks, and you can pretend that they're real paletas. I made 3, because that's how many you can make in your kits. I made horchata, because that's the kind that I like. I also made piña, because that's the kind that the narrator has in Paletero Man. And I also made fresas con crema, which is a kind that I haven't tried before, but I would like to try. So you can make any flavor, if it's your favorite flavor, or if it's just one that you would like to try. So the next book that we're going to read is about another fun thing to do in the summertime, which is actually my favorite thing to do, and that's go to the pool. This one's called Jabari Jumps. It's about Jabari, who's going to jump off of the diving board and do a super cool jump, which can be kind of scary, but also really exciting. All right, let's read. Ooh, this beautiful blue water. Jabari Jumps, and this is written and illustrated by Gaia Cornwall. Here he is getting his swim trunks on and his goggles. Looks like he's ready. I'm jumping off the diving board today, Jabari told his dad. Really? Said his dad. So there's Jabari and his dad, and it looks like his little sister, who's also got her swimsuit on. The diving board was high and maybe a little scary, but Jabari had finished his swimming lessons and passed his swim test, and now he was ready to jump. I'm a great jumper, said Jabari, so I'm not scared at all. He doesn't look scared, does he? He looks excited. Jabari watched the other kids climb the long ladder. They walked all the way out to the end of the board, as big as tiny bugs. Then they stood on the edge. They spread their arms and bent their knees and sprang up, up, up. And then they dove down, down, down. Splash! Looks easy, Jabari said. But when his dad squeezed his hand, Jabari squeezed back. Ooh, so how do you think Jabari is feeling after watching everyone jump up so high? Jabari stood at the bottom of the ladder. He looked up. You can go before me if you want, he told the kid behind him. I need to think about what kind of special jump I'm going to do. Jabari thought and thought. He's letting everyone go in front of him. How do you think he's feeling about jumping? Jabari started to climb up and up. This ladder is very tall, he thought. Are you okay? Called his dad. I'm just a little tired, said Jabari. Maybe you should climb down and take a tiny rest, said his dad. A tiny rest sounded like a good idea. Oh, you can even see his sister, she's saying. When he got to the bottom, Jabari remembered something. I forgot to do my stretches, he said to his dad. Stretching is very important, said his dad. I think tomorrow might be a better day for jumping, Jabari said. They looked up at the diving board together. How do you think Jabari is feeling? He did his stretches. That is very important. It's okay to feel a little scared, said his dad. Sometimes, if I feel a little scared, I take a deep breath and tell myself I am ready. And you know what? Sometimes it stops feeling scary and feels a little like a surprise. Jabari loved surprises. Is that how it feels when you do something scary? It kind of feels like a surprise. Like you did it. Jabari took a deep breath and felt it fill his body from the ends of his hair right down to the tips of his toes. Jabari looked up. He began to climb up and up and up and up until he got to the top. Jabari stood up straight. He walked all the way to the end of the board. Oh my gosh, so exciting. Do you think he's going to be able to jump? His toes curled around. Oh my gosh. Can you see his dad and his sister? They're down there. They look so very tiny because he's up so high. Jabari looked out as far as he could see. He felt like he was ready. I love surprises, he whispered. Wow, can you see his dad and his sister again? Look, you can see the whole city and all of those people swimming. He took a deep breath and spread his arms and bent his knees. Then he sprang up, up off the board, flying! Wow, look at him go! And look, his dad and his sister are waving to him. They're saying, go, Jabari, go! Jabari hit the water with a splash! Wow, look at that big splash. It's all over the page. Down, down, down he went. And then back up. Whoosh! How do you think Jabari's feeling now? Look at his face. Oh my gosh. Jabari, you did it, said his dad. I didn't, said Jabari. I'm a great jumper. And you know what? What, said his dad. What is he going to say? Surprise double backflip is next. Oh my gosh, look, he's already climbing up to jump again. How exciting. The end. Wow, that was so exciting. I'm so happy that Jabari was finally able to face his fears and have a lot of fun. Are you wondering what I'm wearing on my face? They're goggles, just like the ones that Jabari had in the book. And you can make your own in the activity kit that you can pick up from the library. Here, I'll show you how I made them. So in your kit, you're going to have two slices of this paper towel roll. And I stapled mine together, but you can glue them or attach them however you would like to. And then I punched a hole in each one so you can glue the ends of a ribbon. Or not glue, sorry, you can tie the ends of a ribbon into the holes. And then you will have the band for your goggles. I also put some sparkly gems on mine, and you have some in your kit, but you can decorate them with markers or however you would like. And then you can pretend that you're Jabari jumping off the high dive. Right, let me get my regular glasses back on. And we've been reading for a while, so I thought we would take a break and sing a quick song about jumping into the pool. You might know it. It's called Five Green and Speckled Frogs. And I'm going to do some hand actions. You can do them with me, or you can also pretend to be a green and speckled frog and jump into the pool. Ready? Let's start. Five green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now there are four green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Four green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now there are three green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Three green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now there are two green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. Two green and speckled frogs sat on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now there is one green speckled frog. Glub, glub. One green and speckled frog sat on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. She jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now there are no green speckled frogs. Glub, glub. All right, so now that we've taken a short break and sang a little song, let's get back to reading. This next book is called Summer Supper, and it's about a summer feast that you grow in your garden. It's by Ruben Pfeffer, and it's illustrated by Mike Austin. And it's a really interesting book because all of the words in the book start with the same letter. Do you think you can figure out what that letter is? Let's see. Ooh, here is a garden with some things that you can grow in your garden. Let's see. There's spinach and squash and spuds. Do you know what spuds are? It's another word for potatoes. Strawberries and sunflowers. And look, someone's watering them with a hose. Okay. Shovel soil. Sow seeds. Oh, you can see here somebody is tying some string onto these sticks so these flowers can grow so tall. Here are some more sticks. And here are some kids sowing some seeds and some water, and so they will grow with the help of the sun. What other things can you see in this garden? Sprinkle, sprinkle! Someone is sprinkling water on these seeds, and they are growing into little seedlings. Do you see? Exciting. And look, there's a snail crawling on these strings. And there's a bird, too. Do you see any other animals? How about other vegetables or flowers? Sprout, shoot, stalk. So you can see these seedlings are growing and growing into this very tall plant with a very long stem. And underground, do you see what these are? going squiggle, squiggle, squirm, squirm. That's right, they're worms. And do you see what these birds up here are thinking? Thinking scrumptious. Do you know what scrumptious means? It means delicious. So look, they're looking at the worms and thinking, oh, those look scrumptious. Scarecrow, surprise! The scarecrow scared all of these birds, and they're going, squawk, squawk, squawk! He's standing by the flowers, especially these big sunflowers. And look, this bird dropped a strawberry. Oh, no. Snip, snip, snip. Do you see what this person is doing? They are snipping these strawberries and putting them in a big basket. Delicious. Sample, sell. Ooh, someone here is sampling these strawberries. They're going, sweet. And these two are buying an onion. And over here, there's a scale with some peppers on it. Do you see any other kinds of foods? Slice, soak, shuck. Someone here is slicing what I think are potatoes. And these three over here are shucking corn. Have you ever shucked corn before? Sizzle, swirl, swish, saute! Look, someone here is sauteing these vegetables. They're steaming them in a skillet over the stove. Oh, and look, they're using secret sauce and a salt shaker. All these kids are so excited. They must be really hungry, huh? Or impressed by this tossing of the vegetables. Sprinkle spice. Stir salad. Someone's shake, shake, shaking some spice onto this salad. What kinds of vegetables do you see in that salad? Looks delicious or scrumptious. Sniff, sniff, smell. They all look so hungry, and someone here is super excited. They're yelling, succotash! You know what succotash is? I've never had it before, but it's this kind of dish. It has corn and all kinds of beans in it. I've heard it's really good. Everyone thinks so, too. Look, they all look really excited. Even the dog. That is so funny. Silence. Wow, look at this beautiful landscape. And everyone's standing together and being thankful. Share summer supper. They're all serving each other food. Ooh, and someone here is eating one of these sausages. And the dog is thinking, I'm starving. Do you see that? Oh my gosh. Someone here is sippy straw slurping. Look at that twirly, swirly straw. Ooh, everyone is eating. What kinds of foods do you see them eating? Yum. Plates are full. Shimmy, shake, sing. Look, everyone is dancing and singing at sunset. Oh my gosh. Someone even lost their shoe. They were dancing so hard. Everyone here is singing shaboom, shaboom. They're playing instruments. Oh, even the dog is singing. Wow. Wow, what kind of instruments do you see them playing? I've never seen this kind of instrument before. Do you know what that is? Scrub, save, store. It's time to clean everything up. They're cleaning up with a sponge and soap. They're making suds. These two are drying the dishes and stacking them up and saving their food for next time. Sleepy snooze. Look, someone's yawning and someone's already asleep. The baby's even asleep too. They're in their room with all the stars on the walls and Saturn. They have a poster about space and a super shark. Do you see the books that they have on their shelf? They're about science and seashells and what's that? Sailboats and scuba. Time for bed. But look. Shh. Snack. You see someone's having a slice of cake for a midnight snack. Look, someone else is thinking, ooh, I would like some of that. The end. Who knew there were so many summer things and foods that started with the letter S? And you can think up more. When you come pick up an activity kit from the library, you'll find a summer scavenger hunt where you can think of summer things and summer foods and things you can do that start with an S. So let's think. What is something you can do in the summer that starts with an S? Oh, I thought of one. We read about it just a little bit ago. Swimming! That's one of my favorite things to do. I wonder how many things that you can think of that start with the letter S. Alright, we have one last book to read. And it's about another cool thing to do in the summer, and that's go camping. It's called Fatima's Great Outdoors. It's written by Ambreen Tariq, and it's illustrated by Stevie Lewis. And grown-ups, this book is a little longer, so it might be better for older kids. You can try and read it, but if you don't want to, you can skip to the end, where I talk about the activity that goes with this book, which everyone can do. All right, let's read. Fatima's Great Outdoors. Oh, and there's Fatima. Oops, let me scoot over. There is Fatima with a little leaf. Fatima and her appa stood at the curb and waited for their parents to pick them up from school. Today, they weren't going straight home. Today, the Kazi family was going camping for the first time. Camping, her father had told them over dinner in his teaching voice, was a great American pastime. The trip felt like Fatima's reward after a long, hard week. On Monday, some kids wrinkled their noses at her lunch. On Tuesday, someone in class laughed and told her it's pronounced fractions, not fractions. On Wednesday, a boy pulled on her long braid in the hallway. And on Thursday, she didn't do so well on her math quiz. Man, Fatima has had a really hard week. Fatima smiled when her parents pulled up. The sisters piled into the car, squeezing in between pillows, blankets, and a big cardboard box filled with cooking supplies. Wow, this is a lot of stuff, Fatima yelled. Are we moving to the forest? That's so silly. Mama asked the girls in Urdu if they were excited as she reached back to hand them warm homemade samosas. The girls nodded vigorously with jack-o'-lantern smiles. Mama samosas always tasted extra delicious on road trips. How about some ghane? Papa asked. Mohammed Rafi's voice rose from the car speakers and Bollywood songs spilled out from the windows. Fatima's cares melted away as they all sang along in Hindi. Looks like a fun car trip. Appa shouted over the music and announced to the whole car how well she had done on her math homework. Appa's teacher even asked her to come to the front of the class and solve a hard problem on the board that most of the other kids had gotten wrong. Shabash, Papa said with pride. Appa went on and on about school. Fatima slumped in her seat and ate another samosa. Ooh, how do you think Fatima's feeling right now? As Fatima thought about how to change this topic, her big sister pointed out the window and shouted, "Look, we're here!" The family cheered as they passed the sign for the state park. Wow, that looks beautiful. Emerald State Park. Wow. At the campsite, the girls helped their parents unload. First, Papa said, we must build our tent. Appa and Mama chose to start dinner instead. Fatima watched as Papa took the tent gear out of a sack. Ooh, look at all of that. Those beautiful forest things. I see some flowers and some toadstools. What else do you see? Papa grumbled in Urdu when the pieces wouldn't fit. Fatima wanted to help, but could she? She hadn't done anything right at school that week. What would make the campground any different? Fatima took a tiny step closer. She suggested to Papa that they read the instruction manual together. Do you think they're going to figure it out? When they finished, Fatima stood proudly next to their brand new home in the forest. Shabash! Papa's bear claw clapped her shoulder. The Kazi family celebrated the start of their first camping trip over delicious dinner of shami kebab and rotis that Mama had brought from home. Ooh, yum. That does look delicious. After dinner, Fatima and Appa crawled into the family tent. They were so excited to snooze in their new sleeping bags. They never had rooms of their own, not even in India, so being together in one big tent felt cozy and right. The girls zipped up their sleeping bags and chattered on as their parents finished cleaning up. Appa was telling Fatima about how she won her class spelling bee, when suddenly her face dropped. She gasped and pointed to the tent ceiling. 8 long, giant legs gripped the outside of the tent. What do you think that is? A monster! The girls screamed and huddled together. They cried out for Mama. She was fearless and would know what to do. When they lived in India, Mama would catch the lizards and throw them out without flinching. That's why she had that funny finger, Appa said. She had been getting rid of a scorpion from her house when it stung her. Oh, look, do you see? She's got a lizard in her hands. Oh, my gosh. Fatima and Appa look so scared. The monster moved across the roof, and the girls screamed again. What's going on? Mama shouted over the sound of dishes being washed. Cousins didn't use paper plates because they were too expensive. Mama, don't open the tent, Appa yelled. There's a giant poisonous spider monster outside. Don't be silly. It's tiny, Mama replied impatiently. Go brush your teeth before bed. Mama held the tent door flaps, and on the count of 3, the girls ran out. They followed the same precautions, coming back inside. 1, 2, 3. They zoomed into their sleeping bags in a single fluid motion. Do you see their spider monster on their tent? Do you think that's a big spider monster, or do you think it's just a little tiny spider? Oh my gosh, that is so silly. That night, Fatima had a hard time falling asleep. Crickets chirped and wind blew against their tent. She flinched every time a twig snapped. But soon, as the trees swayed outside, Fatima's eyes got heavy and she drifted into a warm, deep sleep that only campers enjoy. Soft snores drifted outside the Cuzzy's tent and joined the sounds of the forest. Wow, look at that beautiful forest. What kinds of things do you see in there? I see lots of lights. It looks like fireflies. Do you see any animals other than fireflies? What about plants? The next morning, Fatima woke up to the smell of andai and roti cooking in ghee. Papa was waiting for her to make the bacon over a roaring fire. He had promised Fatima they could have bacon for breakfast, just like the other American families. They had even made a special trip to the halal butcher shop for the beef kind. Bahir ajao, Papa called for them to come outside. The sisters crept out slowly. Ooh, it looks like they're still scared of the monster. Mama pointed at the top of the tent between chuckles. Go look at your big monster, she said. A harmless little daddy long leg sat quietly between beads of morning dew. It had been guarding them from mosquitoes all night. The girls laughed and laughed. Mama and Papa laughed too. Fatima was pretty sure the spider joined in as well. Do you see that tiny spider? That is so silly. Spiders can be scary, but they do eat mosquitoes, which is great. Let's start the campfire so we can make this smoky bacon you've been so excited about, Fatima, Papa said. 20 minutes later, there was still no campfire. Papa grumbled under his breath in Urdu. The fire wouldn't catch. Fatima looked around at the other families' campsites, and they all had roaring fires. Why couldn't theirs look like that? Why did Fatima's family always have to be so different? She pouted and kicked rocks. Oh, man. Papa kept spraying lighter fluid on the logs. The fire would scream for a second, and then it would be gone. Mama came over to see what all the fuss was about. She shook her head and clicked her teeth in disapproval, the way Fatima's aunties did. That's not how you start a fire. Let me show you, she said. A fire, like strength, takes patience to build. She made the girls gather twigs and dry leaves for kindling, then bigger sticks for tinder. Oh yeah, there are twigs and dry leaves, and then there are some bigger sticks too. Unlike Papa, who grew up in big cities in India, Mama came from a small town where they had to use a wood-burning stove outside to make chai when they ran out of gas for the inside stove. Fatima remembered visiting her nani's house and helping one morning. Mama showed Fatima how to use a long metal pipe to breathe oxygen into the fire. That's how it comes alive, she had said. Fatima remembered that when it was her turn, she'd blown a giant puff of air into the fire, but no one told her not to inhale right after. She got a mouthful of smoke and started coughing. Her cousins had howled with laughter at the city girl. Well, now you know, Mama had said, rubbing Fatima's back as she coughed. Fatima smiled at that memory and watched wide-eyed as Mama blew life into the campfire. Though Fatima hadn't built the fire herself, now she knew how. Look at that roaring fire. That's so exciting. As the Kazi family packed up, Fatima's heart felt heavy. I am so sad, she told Appa. I don't want to go home. Home meant no laughing around the campfire or telling funny stories from India. Here they are packing up, and here they are on a hike. Look at Fatima. She looks so strong. Here they are in the water. That's my favorite thing to do when I go on a hike, is to find some water to stand in. Home meant no long road trips with fresh samosas and Bollywood sing-alongs in the car. Home meant taking tests, doing homework, getting in trouble, and being teased at school. Home meant Mama and Papa would be tired again from working long hours and two jobs each. There they go, they're packing up their car. Fatima looked at the tall trees and the big blue sky and the imprints in the dirt where their tent used to stand. Being outdoors reminded her of how she used to feel in India. She had fun, she didn't feel sad or scared, and she loved how adventure was around every corner. At the campground, Fatima felt like a superhero, but now she had to leave it all behind. Appa rubbed Fatima's back and said, "Don't worry, we'll be back soon. Remember, you can share all this at show and tell." How exciting. Oh, and Appa's giving her a hug. That's so sweet. Oh, look, here she is at show and tell. It says show and tell Mondays. And look, she's talking about her camping trip. There's a spider and the fire and firewood, and there she is. Fatima returned to school with stories of her great outdoors. "Guess what?" she asked her classmates. "I am a superhero. I have lots of superpowers. I can build fires and tents, and I'm not afraid of spider monsters." Fatima beamed as she thought about what the Kazi family's next camping adventure would hold. Oh, and here they are. Their dad is taking a picture. And here someone else is taking a picture of all of these people with a sign that says, "Brown People Camping." Oh, that looks like so much fun. The end. It says there, "Welcome home." Oh, that book makes me want to go camping. And I hope the Kazi family can go camping again sometime soon. All right, for your last activity, you're going to make something that you can use while you go camping, but you can also use it at your house. It's called a shadow puppet. So you have enough materials in your kit to make two shadow puppets. The first one, you're going to make a spider monster, just like the one in the book. Mine only has 6 legs because they keep falling off, but you have enough materials to make the body and 8 legs. So you'll cut them out, glue them together, and then put them on this popsicle stick. And then if you've never used a shadow puppet before, let me show you how to do them. They're super cool. I'm going to go over here and turn off the light. And then what you do, your shadow puppet, is you hold it up to the wall and you shine a flashlight behind it. Ready? Big spider monster! No! Isn't that so cool? It's just like the one in the book that they thought was super big. It was actually really tiny. Come back. Hold on. Alright. So, yes, you have 2 pieces of paper, so you have enough paper to make 2 shadow puppets. You can make a spider monster, and then you can also make another shadow puppet. You can make an animal or a monster or even a person, whatever you want. All right, that is all the stories and all the songs and all the activities that we're going to do today. Thank you so much for reading and singing with me, and I'll see you next time.